Hello fellow theme park builders, Mike here, and it is finally summertime. I did want to get this video to you just before summer to get us all in the mood for the build up, so I am a little late getting this video out, but I have been busy with the real world creations that I have to do to pay the bills. So here we are at a little theme park I have built on Planet Coaster PS4 console edition called Summa Beach, using the deciduous landscape. I will soon be taking this park to PS5, when I will expand the park along with my other parks you can find on the Frontier Workshop. So this is inspired by Clacton Pier and Southend Seafront in Essex, United Kingdom, and also inspired by the Costa del Sol in southern Spain. This park has two amusement parks in one. We have Summa Beach Leisure Pier, kinda central to the park. Then at the far end, way over here, we have a small amusement park that I will expand upon once again when I take it to PS5. One of the main things I wanted to show you in this park is how intricate you can make your buildings and landscape with a little time and thought. So the first major terraforming that had to take place here was the lake, obviously, but if we take a look at the structures along the waterfront here, they are built on two different tiers of the land. So the front of the building here may look like a 3 or 4 story building, then on the back side it only looks like a 1 or a 2 story building. This is inspired mostly by Southend Seafront in Essex and the Costa del Sol in Spain. But as this is PS4, now considered an old gen console, I did have to hold back on how much I did of any one thing so I could get as much variety in here as possible, but I can't wait to take it to PS5 as this park will expand greatly once we get it there. In this park there is some blueprints that you can download separately from my Frontier Workshop profile, like these custom burger and food trailers, if we head down here there is this staff room camper van. These vehicles have been on the workshop for you to download already for some time now, but there is now also these yachts that you can download also. I have a couple of construction sites, but only one is to stay. This small one over here is going to stay when I upgrade to PS5, but if we head way over to the other side of the park, this very large construction site would have been a hotel and theme park complex with at least 2 coasters and a swimming pool, but that will have to wait until I upgrade to PS5. The plan is to have the hotel complex at this end with the pool up on the raised land here that will be looking over the small amusement park that will fill the rest of this area. This end of the park will be overlooking the lake at this end. If you're curious, the company that is building this project is called Plankovia Strov Construction Co. I was a little disappointed I couldn't get a few more details in behind these buildings here, but I'm glad I focused whatever detailing I had available where I've placed it. Oh yeah, I almost forgot, you can also download the blueprints for these construction cranes and the vehicles from my Frontier Workshop profile. This ride has a complete custom flashing lights canopy that I built over the top of the ride from scratch, as I didn't like how the ride was exposed to the elements. Plus, it looks super cool at night time now with all the flashing lights inside. Check it out. As always, the whole park is illuminated in some way at night time, as I always make this a priority to get done within the build limit. Way up in the sky there is another blueprint you can download, and that is my hot air balloons ready and waiting to decorate the skies of your park with. Then if we take a look below us, right down here on the other side of the park, I built this small village purely to frame some awesome shots of the park from across the water. I tried to get in as much authentic detailing as possible, like a parking lot, marina, that I admit was going to be a bigger marina, but I hope to do that on PS5 again. We have railings and drains, seaweed, a shipwreck, islands, rock pools and some caves. You may notice most of the rocks around this park are not scenery props. They are all terraformed and painted to look like rocks to save on unnecessary consumption of the build allowance. I actually enjoy forming the land and rocks rather than placing props, as this requires little creativity and I'm limited to the very similar rounded off rocks that the game offers. Here is a feature I enjoyed making, this tidal breaker causeway that gives my guests some awesome views of the whole beach. As I mentioned, this feature is no different, using no rock props. The whole thing has been terraformed into shape and painted using the floor painter. Oh yeah, not to forget, another blueprint for you to download is my beach pack that consists of surfboards, sandcastles, loungers and inflatables like a rubber ring, lilos and a beach ball, all ready for you to start decorating your sandy beach areas of your park. The giant bucket and sand prop that the game comes with is just way too big to be putting on your beaches, right? Everything surrounds my arcade bar and restaurant strip, and as some of you probably know, I'm a little famous for my arcades on the Planet Coaster console PS4 Frontier Workshop, with three of my arcades floating around the workshop homepage most popular downloads since the game was released. Although having said that, I haven't looked for a while, so my arcades may not actually still be on there. Let me know if I'm still hanging around on the homepage most popular, or if I've been completely knocked off by now. This was built and completed some time ago before I had the expansion packs that offered more amusement arcade machines like the Gumball and the Fortune Teller, for example. If I wasn't way over the build limit, I would have implemented them by now when they was released, but once again, it will have to wait until the PS5 expansion. One thing about building rides on the pier and so close to a large body of water is that the rides have 100% decoration, making every ride in the park very appealing and popular with guests. We have some rolling hills to the rear of the hotel complex, and over here we have the entrance to the park. The entrance is concealed inside this building that when you come through, you arrive at this boulevard that has an instant lively atmosphere as soon as you arrive with the pumping music from all the speakers I have placed around. We've got a little water feature here, just filling in a spot for now, as this will be one of the entrances into the new hotel and park that I will be building on PS5. The boulevard leads you down to the waterfront arcade, bar and restaurant strip, where you can head to the pier, beach or the small park at the far end of the road. About halfway down the boulevard, there is an obscure staircase that leads you up to my poolside area, where you can find entrances to all the hotels. This area has viewing points, pools, restaurants, arcades and some more stairs leading back down to the main strip. I thoroughly enjoyed building this part of the park, and this is the area mostly inspired by southern Spain's Costa del Sol. Yeah, I love this with the overlooking views. If I'm completely honest, I enjoy this kind of designing and building rather than designing and building a coaster. I guess it's because what I do for a living in the real world, but never on this scale, this big, with no limitations of budget and time. I aim to make this area more popular once we get it to PS5 with some more entrances to the hotels up here. I know I'm saying this about my own work, but oh boy, this makes me want to visit Spain. Take a look at that. Okay, enough dreaming, moving on. The beach itself actually has some attractions and path along it to encourage guests to walk along the beach. The only thing I can't get them to do is bathe or paddle in the water. Using the ATM machines and vista viewing points throughout the whole beach keeps each area in constant use by guests. Finally, I guess all I can say is everything has targeted advertisements around the park, encouraging movement of guests from one area to another. This results in a nice spread out of the crowd over most areas of the park. So, for example, this sign here on the entrance to my pier, this sign is actually advertising, let's see, this vista viewing point way over here. Now, this is just a vista point with a life ring stuck to it, but this is encouraging guests that see the sign way over there at the pier to head over here and check out the views from my breaker causeway here. And to be honest, it's well worth the walk for some of the amazing views you get from this vista point. This is the same for every sign around the park. Each one is advertising either a ride, service or attraction. Okay, one last thing. Super Mario and Luigi on the pier here. They also have a blueprint that you can download along with a Rick and Morty, Minions and a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle display pieces that all have been available from the Frontier Workshop for some time now. Okay, I'm going to let you check out some more of this park in a musical montage. We're going to see everything up a little closer and take a ride on some of the attractions. I may do some walkabout guest cam views also if I get the time. I would love to have more time for YouTube, but it's not going to pay all the bills on its own. Not anytime soon anyway, so unfortunately I do have to prioritize my efforts to projects that actually generate some real revenue. If you're interested in what I do in the real world, you can check out my website that can be found on the About section of my YouTube channel called My Other Job. So I'm going to end this Planko season for now, and you may get another one from me at the end of this year when I upgrade my parks to PS5, expand on them and build some new parks from scratch. Be sure to check out the rest of my Planko series and downloads. I hope you like this park and enjoy the download. I'm going to turn off the mic for now, leave you with some views from the rides and the coaster, my usual musical montage, and say thanks for watching. Don't forget to vote up and favourite on the Frontier Workshop when you download. Hit the like, comment and share here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, hit subscribe. Until next time, happy building. We'll be right back.
Thank you. up and yell at the deli.
Yeah.
celebration.
Even Milan also say la vajon.
Say about that, I think you know it's a most fun. And the love for you now, so it's.
Do you know the matter to tell her?
But I must say, I'm
Devil, that's a thousand.
probleme pe cei la motor.
Tu ne sova?
I haven doras nubli una.
Tu spun cam on forse?
Say you're there in Ohio, yes?
Oh, of course, no. Then come on, just balan.
Oh, Janus, smash the cup at you.
Need of Mondalin Lounge at the old me. Rouge, huh?
So Eva Malane o se se la vajoe.
about that photo.
Thank you. Oh,
Padan or Bawanta?
O Cabanom Turco or Belsipu. On Europa, Melanie. Sometimes Esau lives or fight.